telling me that you'll be true. Lies, lies, that's all I ever get from you. Tears, tears, I shed a million tears for you. Tears, tears, and now you're loving someone new. Such a smart girl, and I don't believe what you say. But who do you think you are, girl, to lead me on this way? Hey, lies, lies, I can't believe a word you say. Lies, lies, I'm gonna make you sad someday.
If you have children, they're being lied to in school about where they live. Thank you for taking the leaflet.
You're welcome to Abbey.
That's why we brought our own stand, so that we wouldn't be on anything.
Yeah, no, this has got bylaws, and you need to get permission from this bit. But if you just go over on that pavement over there, you're welcome to.
Really? What, right outside Westminster?
No, you can stay on this side. Look, I'll show you.
Yeah, please. Yeah. Because that's even better for us.
If you don't mind.
Well, Piccadilly Circus is right up there.
Thank you.
I didn't think anyone would be helpful enough to tell us where we thought, oh, they're not allowed to advise us.
That's what we do.
Oh, brilliant.
Well,
yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, excellent. Thank you very much.
Can I ask you a question? What shape do you think the Earth is?
I thought it would be best to just keep it out of the way because we thought it might be in the way of the public. We might build up a lot of.
Yeah, but because this is Great London Authority, they've got loads of bylaws.
Okay.
And you have to have permission.
Oh, right, okay.
That's
the only problem.
Yeah.
Got you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I just say you've been very nice about it? Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah. But can I give you a card?
Yeah.
Yeah, on the back there is a video I think you should watch, 200 Proofs.
Oh,
you realise that we did not live in a spinning ball. We've been brainwashed to believe that.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Please.
There's quite a lot of information to take in. I'll just take a picture. He's actually been on a plane before.
Yeah. Right.
We're going to move it over there, right on the pavement. Right in front of...
Right.
So...
Oh,
yeah. Yeah. And hold there, Ben.
Okay.
We need someone to direct the station.
Yeah.
What do you think? What if I said to you, you were brainwashed at five, as I was, that I lived in a spinning ball?
Oh.
That we don't live in a spinning ball. It's a flat plane we live on.
Well, that's all kinds of stuff. I don't know. take it as it comes, eh?
See that card I give you?
Oh, this one?
Yeah. On the back of that is a very popular YouTube video.
Right.
Called 200 Proofs.
Okay.
200 proofs why we're not living on a spinning ball.
Ah. Oh, well, I'll have a look
at scientific proofs.
Because it's light, heavy objects fall there.
Imagine that room in the medium of air instead of the medium of water. Do you know in water, if you splash your all current go everywhere? Yeah. Same will happen in air.
Okay.
So we measure the air, so we just automatically on the floor. There is an up and down in the universe. You know, when you look up, you look down.
She's like, oh. I said I wanted to keep it out of the way just to not get in anyone's way. She's like, no, you want to be seen.
I like that.
Great customer relations she's got.
Definitely.
Oh, I met this guy in the tube.
Not wrong, mate.
Did you know Brian Hall used to be here? Did you know Brian Hall used to be here?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, right. I met you in the tube train.
Oh, really?
I was banging into your sign, remember, oh, the dog.
Oh, on the thing, yeah.
Yeah, earlier, yeah.
About everything.
Yeah. Are you a critical thinker?
Sorry?
Are you a critical thinker?
I think so.
You think so?
Yeah.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how
can give me 7.
7?
Yeah.
Okay. And on a scale of 1 to 10, how open-minded would you say you are?
8.
8?
Yeah.
Can I ask you what shape you think the Earth is?
Sorry?
What shape is the Earth?
What shape?
What shape is it?
Shape is the Earth. It is spherical.
Spherical?
Yeah.
And why do you think that?
Because that's what we have learned in the school.
It's what you've been told or what you've learned?
Oh, what I have been taught, yeah.
What you've been told?
Yeah.
And you believe that 100%?
Yeah.
Can I ask you, why do you believe that without any proof?
I think now this is a fact. Everyone knows that Earth is spherical.
We don't know that. We used to know that, but now we don't know it. So can you give me any proof that we do live in a spinning ball?
I think during the school they told us many proof about someone when he see the ship coming from away, it will appear first the head of the ship, then the rest of it, which reflects that it must be spherical. The other thing is the image from NASA and photos and these things. Yeah.
Do you see when he said you're open-minded about 8? I hope you're open-minded to what I'm about to say here.
Okay.
The blue marble shots from space has been correlated by a guy called Robert Simon.
Mm-hmm.
And he says on a radio interview that they're not photographs, they're CGI.
What is CGI?
Computer-generated images. Created on a computer. Now, he's stating that they're not photographs.
Mm.
And the ship going over the horizon, If you go on to the beach and look at the ship and use a powerful zoom camera, you'll see the bottom of the ship again.
Okay.
The whole of the ship. Mm. Proving it's not going over any curvature. It's just going out of your line of perspective. Like if you stood at the other side of the park there, I probably wouldn't be able to see your feet. Because that's due to perspective.
Okay.
But there's no evidence of a curvature. When you flew over here to UK, you look out the window, the horizon is flat.
Yes.
It's always flat. Mm. There's no curvature. There's no measurable curvature. Nobody's ever seen the curvature. But NASA present you with fisheye lenses that makes everything look curved.
Okay.
Now, are you still open-minded to this possibility you might have been lied to the shape of the Earth?
Yeah, I can reconsider.
Oh, good.
But I think, because now what I told you that is like a fact.
No, but I'm saying it's not a fact because you can't prove it. It's a fact you and me are sitting here.
Okay.
We can prove that.
Yeah.
But you believing that we've been to space and walked on the moon, you can't prove that. Because that's second-hand information.
Yes.
It's a belief, is it not?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A belief could be right, could be wrong.
Yes.
But if for a belief, it should be able to prove it. Like, I don't need a belief that you and I are sitting here. It's a self-evident truth.
Okay.
It's a belief for me that there might be two people in there talking, because I can't see them.
Okay.
But this is primary observation. Scientific observation.
Yes.
I can see the ship on the horizon. It's not going over any curvature. Nobody's ever given evidence of a curvature. It's never been measured. It can't be seen.
Okay.
We live in a flat plane. You've been lied to. at school, as I was, you were 5 years old, impressionable, naive, you believed authority, you believed your parents.
Okay.
You didn't develop your critical thinking. But now as an adult with critical thinking, being open-minded, I'm asking you to consider the possibility, because all you have is a belief and second-hand information that you've been lied to. And you don't live on a magical spinning ball with water going around it. That's insane, isn't it?
Actually, for me, it doesn't matter whether it is spherical or it is flat. But I think what you are telling us could be right, yeah.
Well, thanks for being open-minded to that.
Yeah.
I know it is right. I know we're not on a spinning
okay.
ball. Because water cannot conform to the exterior of a ball. That's impossible. If you look at the behaviour of water, it always finds its own level. But yeah, you're supposed to suspend that observation and believe that water can exist around a ball. How does water exist on a ball?
I think it's something related to the gravity, something like this.
But then, can you prove gravity holds water to a ball?
No.
It's a belief again.
Yes.
Yeah. So you were told you lived on this ball, but at the same time you were told about Santa Claus and the Tooth Fairy.
Yeah.
You were gullible and we were naive, and we trusted authority, we trusted parents. But there's absolutely no proof that we live in a ball. I discovered this about 4 years ago. I'm quite ashamed to say that all my life I never even thought about, never even critically thought about the validity of living on a ball. And nobody does, because people are brainwashed. I was brainwashed into believing I lived on a spinning ball with water going around it. It's insane.
Yeah, it could be. Still, I'm telling you that I'm open-minded, so everything is possible.
Would you be willing to watch a video on YouTube?
Yeah.
It's called 200 Proofs.
200 Proofs?
Yeah, I'll give you a card of it. 200 Proofs why it's impossible to be living on a spinning ball.
Okay, I'll check.
Scientifically?
I will check.
That's my YouTube channel where this will go on.
Okay.
And that's the video there.
Okay, I'll check it.
Okay.
Okay?
Thank you. Thank you very much
thank
for
you.
Your time.
Thank you very much. You.
It's mainly about open-minded, people being open,
yeah.
broad-minded.
Good, you know? That's good. I'm very open-minded.
Oh, good.
And one of my missions in the world is to help people open their minds. Yeah.
So could you tell me on a scale of 1 to 10, how open-minded do you think you are?
I guess 9.
9?
Yeah, I guess I would say 10, but we always can be more open-minded, so.
Yeah. I think more people I ask, the higher that becomes.
Yeah.
Okay, to the best of your knowledge, has your mind ever been susceptible to being brainwashed?
Brainwashed?
Yeah.
Yeah, indeed I was when I was a little kid.
Uh-huh.
My dad brainwashed me and my brother. Well, telling us things about my mom, so I was raised like really brainwashed. When somebody asked me like, what about your mom? And I used to say like, well, I don't have a mom. She's a slut, and she sold me because my dad used to tell me that. And yeah, I think that we are all kind of brainwashed through TV, through education, through even family normally brainwashed with concepts about love, about society. Everything.
That's really interesting, because when you ask a lot of people, have you ever been brainwashed? No. It's part of their ego where they say, no, nobody could brainwash me.
Nah.
Then you meet somebody who's more honest and say, yeah, of course I've been open to brainwashing, especially by the mainstream media, education and government.
Yeah, well, especially here, like with all these statues, like they say that these are the heroes of England, but indeed they are. This guy Churchill was Hitler, practically, you know. Indeed, I came here like to give people information about who was Churchill, you know. And he was a racist.
Yeah.
There's a lot of racism, super well documented, you know. And even the people working with him were saying that he was a Hitler, you know.
Yeah. From what you know now in life, do you think you could ever be brainwashed again?
I think we're all kind of subconsciously brainwashed, you know.
Yeah.
Like our mission in life should be like going up, making our minds more open and realizing which are our own truth and which are the truth that they taught us, you know, because, well, as I say, like through family, through education, through TV, through government, we all have these things in our head that are not our own truth, and it's important to ask ourselves which is our truth and what makes sense for us, you know.
Yeah, well, I'm finding you already completely open-minded, which is absolutely great to see. To dismiss something without inquiry is not very intelligent. Would you agree with that?
dismiss something without what?
Without inquiry.
Uh-huh.
It's not very intelligent. Would you agree with that?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, great. The truth should not fear being challenged or investigated. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Do you think people in general would prefer a comforting answer to the truth?
Yeah, of course.
And what about yourself personally? Would you prefer the truth or a comforting answer?
I prefer the truth. As I said, truth is so relative, but I think that we have to go beyond what we think is truth and question everything, especially what they tell us what is truth. We have to ask ourselves everything.
And do you mean that 100%?
Yeah, for sure.
Mm-hmm. Do you think your thoughts are your own thoughts?
Huh?
Your thoughts that you have.
Are they
your own?
As I said, in great part, yes, because I think that I'm quite aware, and thanks to my experiences, I have been like opening my mind and questioning everything and find my own truth. But as I said, also like we are probably also in a great percentage like brainwashed, you know, like our truth that they taught us since very young, you know, for being in the Western civilization, we all are Christians, for example, you know, whatever we wanted or not, we have in our subconsciousness all the stuff, you know, and all that our family teachers or school, everything like get in our subconsciousness, and that goes beyond what we can choose to believe or not, you know. So it's important to go questioning that. And
yeah, that's excellent, brilliant. So in talking to me now, how can you discern that your thoughts are completely your own, or that they're being manipulated into you? How do you know they're your own thoughts?
I don't know really. As I said, like many thoughts are just part of this brainwashing, you know. But I know that most of my thoughts are my own, because they are very different of what people think, of what my family taught me. I'm like the opposite, or what society taught me. I like try to go a bit against that and question everything, and try to make people also question themselves the truth that they were told, and what they really think, because the mind is very difficult. We are like mostly subconscious, you know. So our consciousness is just a little bit, and we don't know what is inside now.
Do you think there's such a thing as original thought?
I don't know really. It is said that we cannot create anything new; that everything is created, and. I also believe that there is like a kind of collective subconsciousness. I don't know. I think that when we are like connected with ourselves and with the universe and with everything, we kind of channelize some universal truth. Yeah. You know.
And how do you discern? You've been told the truth about the world by education, by the parliament.
How
the
do
media.
I what?
How do you discern, how do you know what's true and what's false from what you've been told by the media, education, school?
Well, researching, though the information is very, very manipulated, so we cannot, well, I think we can never know what is really true. So I think it's important to never think that we own the truth, you know, because all the truth, I think it's relative, and I think it's always important to give space for doubt, you know, and hear, listen to other truths and say, and be able to change also, to say, oh, well, that makes sense, and find our own truth and truth that are healthy for us, you know?
Yeah.
People can believe whatever they want, but it's important to find some truth that it makes you happy, it makes you healthy, it makes you connect with people real way.
So on a scale of 1 to 10, how open are you to listening to something which goes against everything you believe?
Well, I intend to be 100% open, but like from 1 to 10, I intend to be 10, but I'm never into extremes, so I would say 8. I try to be 10, but I guess I'm 8. Oh. But I guess I'm 10, I don't know.
Well, I'm going to ask you a controversial question now.
Right? Yes, please.
After discussing openness and listening to a difference of opinion, can I ask you what shape you think the Earth is?
I guess it's kind of round, like a kind of oval, how do you say, ovalado, or like
a spherical.
Like, yeah, like kind of egg. I've seen some pictures that is a bit deformed, but I don't know, I guess for the gravity, for the universe, well, how it's like turning, I guess it's, it must be like quite round, you know?
And can I ask you why you believe that?
It makes sense for me.
Okay.
Like the planets, the from the creation of the Earth. I don't believe this flat at all. I'm not a flat Earth.
Okay. If I was a child coming into the world now and said that doesn't make sense to me, a ball with water going around it. I mean, how can water exist going around a ball? Well, what would you say to that?
Through gravity, that is something that that is very difficult to understand, because the laws of physics are so complicated and undiscovered either. Like, I think that most of things that we believe are half truth but half not. Like, we are all, there are always new and new discoveries, you know. So I'm open-minded to everything.
Okay, if you're open-minded, what have I said to you? You do not live in a spinning ball, water going around it.
Yeah, I could say that, yeah, maybe if I can see some other, if there is like good fundamentals.
In the next few minutes, I'll hopefully convince you that what you believe is not true.
Uh-huh.
I believe the exact same thing. These people here with me, millions of others, are waking up and realizing that all we had was a belief. We had no evidence that we lived on a spinning ball of water going around it.
Mm-hmm.
And this gravity that we're told to accept, it's never been proven. It's never been proven that gravity can hold water to a ball.
Mm-hmm.
And if you watch the behavior of water, it always lies flat. The world's made up of flat water. But yet, that's your natural observations telling you that. All your senses see that. But we're supposed to believe authority telling us.
But in the moon and the shadow of the Earth in the moon, for example, the eclipses. How would you explain that if the Earth would be flat?
Yeah, I'll get onto that. But I'm just trying to get you to see that water does not behave that way. It cannot exist to the exterior of a ball. It's never been proven. Now, science is supposed to be demonstrable. And demonstrable.
Uh-huh.
And they can't do that. They can't demonstrate a model with a ball of water going around it.
Mm-hmm.
Because gravity doesn't exist. But we believe it does because we're told it does. But the people in these parliaments told you gravity holds water to a ball, and at 5 years old we believe that without really using our critical thinking. So, hold on a minute, water around a ball, that's ridiculous. People upside down on a ball, that's ridiculous. Now, if you were on the so-called International Space Station looking back at Earth, through a telescope, you'd have to see planes flying upside down, going up and going down round that ball, would you not?
Not necessarily. No, for me it makes sense that it's a ball, like cells, you know. I think like it's like how it's up, it is down, you know, like the microcosmos is like the macro. So like it makes sense, like the atoms and the cells, you know, like spinning around the center, like the sun and the planets. For me it makes sense. Maybe I'm wrong, maybe all these are big conspiracy, and all the footage of in space is fake. Maybe, I don't think so.
I'm always open to space.
Huh?
Nobody's been to space.
I think they have, but who knows? You never know.
But I think
is
that a belief?
And I know it would not make me believe that, that the Earth is flat. But
is that a belief or a knowing that people have been to space?
A belief, or
it's a belief.
Unless it's a, or I don't know. Who knows? Be like a whole conspiracy. But I don't know. I'm not such. I was very into conspiracy theories. Now I think that of course it's full of conspiracies. But for me, it really makes sense. That
this is not a conspiracy theory. I'm challenging what we've been told. What we've been told is not the truth. And all we have is secondhand information and a belief.
Yeah.
There's absolutely no proof that we live on a ball with water going around it.
Yeah, I don't give a shit. I choose to believe that is true. For me, as I said, it makes sense until someday I kind of go to space or something and I can prove that it's flat, then I will believe that it's flat.
Okay.
Until now, I believe that it's round because for me, it makes sense.
When you flew here from Germany, you look out the airplane window, the horizon is flat. Every time you see the horizon from a mountain, a plane, beach, it's flat.
Not necessarily. I was in Bariloche in Argentina, and you can see quite round, you know, it's so vast, so big, and you can see kind of round. So,
Now, no disrespect, but everybody who claims to have seen the curvature, I say, have you got evidence of that? Do you have a photograph or a video of that? And everybody goes, no. I bet you don't have a picture of that either. No?
Yeah.
You have a picture?
Yeah.
Can you show me?
Not here, it's in Chile.
If you ever go on YouTube, if you watch a video called 200 Proofs, it lists 200 reasons why it'd be impossible to be living on a spinning ball with water on it.
Okay, I will check to see, but as I said, I'm a bit blinded.
Can I use this for my YouTube channel?
Yeah, sure.
I'll show you where my YouTube channel is.
Okay.
But see, when you admitted you've been brainwashed.
Huh?
See, when you admitted you were brainwashed earlier by your father.
Everybody's fighting is we're brainwashed.
Well, the brainwashing is always there. And we always think we're here, we've reached it, we'll never be brainwashed again. But there's always clever manipulation and lies.
Yeah, we're all the time brainwashed. So maybe you're right and we live in the Earth flat. If I were you, I would never, as I said, it's not good to say this is the truth because we cannot know.
I never said this is the truth. All I'm saying is it's not a ball we're living on.
I said to when you say I know this is because you think that you own the truth, but you can never know. It's good to leave open the space for maybe we live in a circular sphere. Who knows?
Yeah, but you know when they say the ships go over the curvature, right? I go to the beach and I use my zoom camera and I see the bottom of that boat again, the whole of the boat, proving it's not going over the curvature. So there, that's a fact that it's not going to recover. So I know that's not going.
But there are much more things that we cannot see of what we are, of where we live.
I can give you 200 proofs that we don't live on a spinning ball.
But then there are like thousands of proofs that we do. So
could you give me one?
I'm not a scientist. I have read, but I don't remember.
No, but you have a belief that you're on a ball. So people say there are many proofs, but I say there's not. Just give me one. And people cannot give me one.
The eclipse, the shadow of the moon in the the shadow of the Earth in the moon. Yeah. You know, for me,
but does that prove that Earth is causing that shadow?
Huh?
Does that prove that Earth is causing the shadow?
Yeah, of course. What else you can see in the eclipse the eclipse moment?
You said there's lots of things we don't know.
Otherwise, how could it be?
Could be anything. Far advanced technology than you're aware of.
Okay, I will take it. I don't believe it, but who knows?
But you said you were open-minded.
And I'm open-minded. I tell you that otherwise I would say that's not true. No, who knows? We can never know the truth.
If we could just end in, is there any possibility, do you think, in your head, that what you've been taught and what you believe about the Earth may be wrong? Is there any possibility?
Yeah, sure. As I said, there's always possibilities. I don't think so, but there is possibility.
On the back of that card, if you put that into YouTube and watch that video, I don't think you'll be saying what you're saying now.
We will see. I don't think that you can convince me that the Earth is flat. It's a bit ridiculous for me, but I would take it out.
Yeah, maybe, but I can't, but I think that video will.
Okay, let's see.
Thank you very much for your time anyway.
YouTube, 200 proofs Earth is not a spinning ball. Please take a leaflet. I promise you it will change your life. The Earth is not a spinning ball.
There's a leaflet, so if you didn't manage to get all the information. No worries.
Would you mind me if I asked you for my YouTube channel? Your response to that?
Would you, once again?
Could you tell me what your response is to looking at that?
Well, my response is, not yet, but just wanna. Well, is that, they're trying to tell me the Earth is flat? Is that what it's all about?
It's more we're questioning what we've been told.
We're questioning what we've been told, but I won't question that. There's too many evidences in that direction, so...
Could you give me one evidence?
That the globe is round, for instance? Yes, for instance, if you... first of all, you can travel around the globe. You can see the sun rise You can see a ship rising in the horizon, and you can send a satellite in orbit. It's all quite satisfactory according to Newton's law and Einstein's law for that matter.
I mean, you say quite a lot of things there, but let's just say that's the whole of Earth, that sign. I could circumnavigate that sign and come back to where I started from, and I did that on a flat surface.
Well, I don't really believe you can, but...
Can we just stay with that? I can walk around this. Can we cover one point at a time?
Yeah.
If I go around here, walk here, and come back, have I not circumnavigated that on a flat surface?
If you go around, you have a circle. Yes, you have made a circle, of course.
So, Earth doesn't need to be a ball to circumnavigate it. It can be a flat surface.
I'm not quite sure I follow your argument.
Well, let's just say that's all the continents on Earth.
Yeah.
I can circumnavigate that by walking around it and coming back to where I started again.
Yes, of course.
But I'm on a flat plane.
Yes, you can. If you change direction all the time, slowly change direction.
Yes, yeah.
And move in a circle.
Yeah, so I'm just proving the point that we don't have to be on a ball to circumnavigate the Earth. Nobody has circumnavigated the Earth between north and south. Did you know that?
Nobody has what, navigated from north to south?
Yes.
It's difficult, of course, to move from north to south unless you're on a plane.
Well, you could get a drone.
How do you explain the images?
Do you mind standing there? Because I'm picking up the noise of the bus.
The images we have from space.
Okay.
How do you explain them?
Okay, I'll explain them to you.
Spinning the cube.
I'll explain them to you. First of all, how open-minded would you say you are on a scale of 1 to 10?
I don't get it. Sorry?
How open-minded are you on a scale of 1 to 10?
I'm open-minded, but I'm also a scientist.
Oh, good.
So,
good. Right.
Because I believe in science.
Okay. I believe in natural science.
Yeah.
Natural observations.
Yeah.
Right. Now, the images you see from space, the blue marble shot of Earth every year, they present you with a picture of the Earth as the blue marble. Mm-hmm. Now, the guy who creates them, you can research this yourself, I don't expect you to believe me. The guy called Robert Simon, he creates that blue marble shot, and he admits on a radio show that it's Photoshop. It's not photographs.
Okay.
So we have no photographs of Earth from space. They're all CGI or Photoshop.
So it's all fake, you mean?
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah. And
now you might find...
We've never been on the moon either.
Do you believe they went on the moon?
Yes, of course.
Why do you believe that?
Because first of all, yes, because of course I followed in during the times. And I mean, it's quite... see the rockets go up, and you can follow the radio signals.
Now we see people sitting in the rocket ready to go, and then we see like Tim Peake, a British astronaut. Mm. The next time we see him, he's on the International Space Station. Ta-da! Now my critical thinking is asking, why is there not a camera on that rocket so I can see the full journey? Now leaving the Earth orbit, going into a vacuum of space, that's the biggest achievement of mankind. Why is that not filmed?
Technical?
You can put cameras all over that rocket.
Typical, I believe.
Right?
That's what it's all about. But anyway, thanks for the chat. I'm glad to walk on. You haven't convinced me.
No, I don't think you've given me time to convince you, but could I give you a card at least?
No.
I think we got the card from...
No, this card here. This is the most popular video on YouTube.
Okay.
It's called 200 Proofs.
Okay.
And we go through every point scientifically.
Okay, I'll take it in. I'll put it
in. Thank you.
High level. Was it high level?
The
horizon?
What
if you lived on a ball?
You do not live on a spinning ball! Open channel! You are not spinning right now! You are on a stationary plane! Earth is not a rotating sphere. Prove me wrong. Challenge a flat earther today. If you have the balls.
It would have to be bigger than Cavendish's. Do you believe you live on a ball, Earth?
Ah, the question is, I think that if the world is a circle?
Yes.
I don't know. That's what they
tell you.
They tell me, and it's too easy to say yes, but don't.
And we did say yes when we were 5 years old, because we knew nothing better. Go, yes, okay. But we've no evidence that we live in a spinning ball.
Yeah.
We're here to tell everybody that the Earth is flat.
Yeah.
It's not a ball we live on. We've been brainwashed into thinking it does.
Wow, that sounds good. Yeah.
Now the Earth is supposed to be spinning 1,000 miles an hour.
What?
The Earth is supposed to be spinning 1,000 miles per hour.
Yeah.
And you look at those flags, how still. You look at those flags and you see how still they are. We're not spinning.
Yeah.
We're not spinning around. I'll give.
That's right.
Do you mind if I put this on my YouTube channel?
Please. Yeah, sure.
That's my YouTube channel.
Okay.
But if you look at this video here, it's in Spanish as well.
Oh, good.
200 proofs why you're not living on a spinning ball.
Thanks.
And once you watch that,
I will see that.
And once you watch that, you'll realise I've just believed everything I was told without evidence.
Oh my god.
It's brainwashing.
Thanks.
Okay, millions and millions of people are waking up realising that.
Yeah, I'm waking up too.
Good. We were all brainwashed by them. Yeah.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Bye. At first, be sorry if there was a murder, you know, and then don't try and find out the motive afterwards. So that's what I'd implore you to do. First of all, find out if it's a crime. If there is a crime, then I think the answer could be quite hard to you at the moment. So,
I've heard the
He was trying to weigh the moon and the planets, wasn't it? That's what he was trying to do.
Yeah,
and if you look at the case apart, there's no actual proof that matter attracts matter.
Are you here all day?
We're here for a few hours, but we basically go across the country, like enlightening people. Millions of people are waking us today.
Right. Right. So you'll see this as well.
In Australia, it's been born true.
Is that what they do?
Don't again, can you prove gravity?
That's alright, it's alright, it'll be okay.
Here's the question.
No, you can't see it, you can't, but you feel it.
Do you feel it?
Yeah.
Do you feel it? Because the reason that you're sticking onto the spinning ball, you believe, is gravity. Well, wouldn't it be easy to explain that as density and buoyancy?
Well, something there's too many scientific proofs with Newton and...
Is that?
Einstein and the rest, and they're a lot smarter than I am, and they believe in it.
See, I've dissected it myself, I've done my own research, and there's...
What's your credentials? What school did you go to get all this information?
I'm just a normal person like yourself, We're more natural scientists. We've all got the ability to work out what's right, what's wrong, and do simple experiments like this. Now, this is simple, but once it sinks in, you'll understand why it's so
beautiful.
Sometimes
the simplest things will just lead you, totally, in a wrong direction.
You see the people who go to university, I've been myself, but they are the ones who are more convinced that what they're being told is true. But there's no proof that we live on a spinning ball with water on it.
Well, I've done a lot of transatlantic flights, mm-hmm. and I know that my route takes me in a circle as I come from the U.S. Yeah. to Britain or back. It's not a constant heading. It changes.
Yeah, but we could go in a circle here. That doesn't mean to say that the pavement's a ball. I'm just putting to you that perhaps what you're told is not true because all we have is secondhand information and it's a belief. We can't verify any of it ourselves. And when they tell you there's distant planets light years away, we can't verify that.
Well, you can. When you look at the moon, it's not flat. It's a circle.
Yeah, it's a circle.
So if you were on the top of the moon and you walked around it, you think that you would feel like you're on a circle or on a flat plane? If you're on the top of the moon,
I don't even believe that you can land on the moon.
Well,
I don't
I'm not
even
saying
believe
if you land on
a solid object.
But I'm just saying, you can see it up in the sky, and it looks like a circle, right?
So I presume you still believe you're at the top of that,
and you walk around to the bottom.
Yeah.
You're walking around a circle, but while you're walking on it, you don't feel like you're walking on a circle.
Yeah, but neither of us have been to the moon. I can't experience that myself. My instincts tell me if I walk around a circle and I get so far, I'm going to fall off. That's what my instincts tell me.
I look in my telescope and I can see Jupiter and I can see Saturn and they're all circles.
Yeah, but you can't see.
And they do spin. Now the moon spins, but because of the way it spins, it always has the same face towards us, but not the other planets.
You can't see in 3D. So all you can honestly say to yourself is that you're looking at a disc shape. You can't prove it's a sphere because it's 2D. The human eye looks with 2D. Not 3D.
No. I can see it in 3D. My eye works in 3D. I can see you in 3D. I see the front of your nose, I see the back of your head.
No, you can't see the back of my neck.
I can see the back of your head. From the nose to your ear, I can see 3D.
Yeah, no, that's 2D. 3D would be looking right.
You could 1D, try, you could 2D would be, you would be just a flat, you would be a flat plane.
Okay, what is 2D?
But I can see you and around the back of your head.
But you can only see one side at a time of that disc in the sky. We can't prove it's a sphere.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
I'd like to pose you a question.
We'll agree to disagree.
But you've took some information.
I got it.
So you can have a look.
I will look.
Investigate. Excellent. That's all we wanted. Thank you.
I'm always intrigued by alternating opinions and perspectives.
Good. So would you class yourself as being open-minded?
Yes.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how open-minded would you say you are?
As much as possible, so 10.
Great. Brilliant. So how open are you to listen to something which goes against what you already believe?
I don't want to be in a bubble. I don't like staying in bubbles.
Neither did I. Now, I believed everything I was told about this world to 4 years ago before I started doing more research. And finding out that things like this guy here, he creates those shots and he admits they're not photographs.
Yeah.
There's no photographs of Earth from space. And when cameras supposedly travel in space, why is there not cameras all over that rocket to let us see that magnificent journey of leaving Earth orbit into a vacuum?
But have you ever seen SpaceX launches?
Do you think they're real?
Do you think they're all fake?
It's not real. And you can have as much people there, the paid actors, as you want.
So the money all goes to paid actors and CGI, then?
Well, NASA get $52 million a day. Right? Now, you cannot see any real footage of a rocket in space or a satellite in space.
Assuming that it's all CGI.
Well, there's very little footage, and the little footage you do see is quite obvious. They don't even hide the fact that it's CGI.
But No, I'm confused though, because there's a lot of footage showing things leaving the Earth. There's footage of people looking at telescopes, seeing the International Space Station go by. So how can that be faked?
Well, I say show me the footage of a rocket leaving space going to Earth orbit. There isn't any footage of that.
Alright, so let's say Sputnik, for example. Sputnik was a hoax.
I've not looked into Sputnik, but I don't believe anybody's been to space.
Okay. You think, is it impossible to go to space?
Yeah, it's an illusion.
Why is it impossible to go to space?
Because I don't think space exists.
Okay. One thing I am curious about is how do, are there other planets in our solar system? Is there a solar system?
Yeah, but I'd ask you, how do you know there are planets?
Because they're observable.
Are they?
In the sky, yeah. So, is the sky CGI?
Well, could you describe to me what you're observing?
Planets.
Well, can you describe what?
They are spherical looking objects.
How do you know they're spherical though?
Because they have a crescent, and because sometimes sides of them are dark and sometimes they're not, and all of this is in alignment with the sun and the rotation of the solar system.
But I could produce a painting like that, and you'd think it was a ball, but it's not, it's just a painting.
But if you did get a telescope and you actually look through the lens isn't creating a CG image.
No, but all it can prove to you is it's a disc-shaped circle. You can't prove that it's a spherical through looking through a telescope. And there's been 5 scientific experiments that prove the Earth does not move. Did you know about those?
Have they been peer-reviewed?
Yes, they're historical facts.
Where have they been peer-reviewed, and what journals?
In historical scientific journals all around the world.
Like what?
I can't refer to them, but if you go online research...
But if you find them so important, then wouldn't you be able to mention the names of the journals?
I can mention the names of the experiments, but I think they've been documented everywhere, but they're not taught in schools.
Because NASA has a vested interest in keeping people brainwashed.
Well, you said that, but I mean, I would have to question. I say to science students, are you science students yourself?
I'm a designer.
A designer. I say to science students, you study science, but you don't know about these 5 scientific experiments to prove the Earth doesn't move. Why don't you know about them? But they concluded that the Earth does not move. Yet,
and those 5 scientific experiments outweigh every other scientific experiment.
Well, what other scientific? There's only one, being Copernicus, who stuck 2 sticks in the ground and claimed that the Earth.
Well, no, because I mean, in order for people to show that things could go up into space, you needed to have experiments that would allow them to do so.
So what experiment has proved that we live in a ball?
Well, I mean, you've got Galileo. You've got Einstein.
What did Galileo prove that we lived in a ball?
He proved that the sun doesn't. We revolve around the sun. The sun doesn't revolve around the Earth.
How did you prove that?
By showing star patterns, and that there are other planets out there that also revolve in the same sort of orbital pattern that the Earth does around the sun.
I mean, that's all secondhand information, isn't it?
No, because it's observable. And
it's observable that the sun rotates around us?
Yes.
But we're told that we go around the sun.
Yeah.
So which is it?
No. There was no observable evidence that the sun rotated around the Earth, but there was evidence to show that the Earth rotated around
and
the sun.
What evidence was that?
Like I said, the star patterns and the other planets moving in similar rotations.
But how does that prove to me that I'm spinning around?
Observation through telescopes. They actually observed it with their eyes.
But I've not observed it.
You personally, but that doesn't mean that they haven't.
No, it doesn't, but what it means is that you've adopted what somebody else has told you, and you're accepting that as fact.
Unless you've seen it yourself with a telescope.
Yeah. But then, if we can't verify it ourselves, then I'm asking, why should we believe it if we can't verify it ourselves?
But how would a solar system function?
But actually, you believe a solar system, I don't.
So, what are there other planets then?
Like, no, I don't believe that either.
Jupiter doesn't exist.
But you'd have to be honest with yourself and say, that's a belief. You believe these.
Well, I've seen it with my own eyes, that's the difference.
Well, you've seen a disc in the sky, that's all you've seen.
And those are all just other discs.
They could all be lights. I don't know what they are. I'll be honest with myself. I'm saying that I can't prove what they are. A lot of people listen to what they've been told and then they repeat what they've been told without really any proof.
But you can prove this, though.
I can prove that we're on a flat plane, yes. No, sorry. I can prove we're not on a spinning ball, yes. Through many natural scientific experiments. Have you been on the beach where you think a ship is going over the horizon?
Yes.
No. Well, you take a zoom camera.
Yeah.
I've done it with many people beside me. They look through a telescope or a zoom camera and they see the hole at the bottom of the boat again. Proving it's not going over an Everett curvature because a lens cannot go over a curve. So that's proving that the ship is just going out of your perspective. It's not going down any curvature. And you can go on YouTube and you can film the sun where you think it's halfway down the horizon. But the new camera is a really powerful camera called the P900. It zooms in and you see the space between the sun and the horizon again. Showing you the sun doesn't go down the horizon, it just goes beyond your perspective. Now, when you said you're open-minded,
yeah.
You've been given a lot of knowledge and education that you live in this ball.
Yeah.
I'm coming along here now saying, perhaps what you're told has not been true. How open are you to listen to a difference?
Well, if there's verifiable evidence that what you're saying is correct, then I would be open to changing my mind about it.
Robert Simmons there, who...
But this is all second-hand information then, isn't it? This is what somebody else has told you, isn't it?
It's second-hand information, but that's the guy who produces it. You can research it, but he produces this picture of Earth.
But your argument stands the same as mine, saying that other scientists have said otherwise, though.
Yeah.
So what is to say that this one is any more...
You could be totally right, but I don't think you said that about me when I told you about the five scientific experiments, and you kept referring to Galileo. But since then, there's been other scientific experiments showing that the Earth doesn't move. And I'm just appealing to you to research it yourself and see all the evidence which contradicts what we've been told.
I will.
And if you watch the behaviour of water, water always finds its own level. Water cannot conform to the exterior of any shape. And they'll tell you it was gravity at 5 years old.
So what about like a water droplet, for example?
Yes.
That's a sphere, isn't it?
It is a sphere, the weight of it falling down. But we're talking about... a magical force that holds all vast oceans to a ball.
What is that magical force? Is there a name for it?
Well, we both know what the name
gravity.
Is, but it doesn't exist.
It's like a
hotspot. If I drop this camera, is there any proof to convince us that there's a force pulling that to the ground?
Yes, the fact that it'll fall.
Could there be any other reason because it falls?
Not that we know of.
Well, we do know because density and buoyancy explains why things drop. The molecules of this camera is heavier than the atmosphere, so it's going to drop.
Yeah.
A helium balloon is lighter than the atmosphere,
yes.
So it will rise.
Yes.
Simple. We don't need this magical gravity that can't hold butterflies down, but it can hold vast oceans to the ball. You know, it's ridiculous. It's selective. The fact is, it's never been proven. That's why it's called the theory of gravity.
But theory, calling something a theory doesn't necessarily mean that it's just one supposition, you know. Theories are usually backed up with enormous amounts of evidence and are strengthened by people questioning their validity.
Well, I would say theories are backed up with evidence when it can be proven as a fact.
Yes.
If it's not backed up with evidence, then it can't be accepted as a fact. Now, science should be demonstrable, repeatable and measurable.
Which it is.
Science cannot produce a working model of a ball of water behind it.
If you assume that it's all CGI.
No, I'm just saying that science cannot produce that.
Well, no, like if I was to show you a video of SpaceX and you told me it was CGI, that's your excuse for it not being possible.
Well, it's not an excuse. I'm just not buying that. I'm not believing that. I need more proof than a video or something on a screen. I need to see real proof. That's evidence. But
have
evidence.
You ever been on an airplane?
Yes.
So on an airplane, don't you see that there's a curvature?
No.
Have you ever been like across the world?
I used to paraglide myself.
Yeah, but I'm talking about like an extended flight on an airplane where the sun goes across to the other side of the planet.
But everybody who claims to have seen the curvature from a plane, my question is, did you take a photograph of that? Can you show me?
I have photographs of it, yes.
Can you show me?
I'm sorry, I am kind of in a bit of a rush. I have to catch a train back to Cambridge.
But do you have photographs of the curvature?
Yes, of course.
Can you show me them?
not at the moment. I don't have anything.
I don't mean to disrespect you, but
yeah.
If I told you I photographed Loch Ness Monster yesterday, would you believe me?
No.
Right. So why should I believe you when you say you see a curvature? I mean, we've all flown for years as well. We've never seen a curvature.
For one, I mean, lots of people take pictures from airplanes and they all show the same images.
Yes, but a lot of people use a GoPro camera, which curves the horizon, which NASA have.
But if you use a cell phone or a regular DSLR...
Do you see this? If you research how an airplane is built, it's tubular shape. The windows are tubular shape. So there's three layers of windows and they're all curved.
But when you look at a straight object, it doesn't curve, though.
But your glass is curved, it's three of them.
But you don't see that with anything else, though. If you were to look at a street outside of an airplane window, it would still appear to be straight. It wouldn't curve.
But how much of a street could you see through a window?
Enough.
Oh, well. But anyway, I've offered people a lot of money to show me a photograph of the curvature. I've been doing this for 4 years. Nobody's ever shown me it.
But if someone was to show you, let's say, hypothetically, somebody shows you a picture of curvature, what's to stop you from saying that it was faked?
Well, it shouldn't be anything to stop me. I should be allowed to have an observation of that photograph.
No, I know, but like you just said, if I was to show you a video of SpaceX with a rocket going up into space from the rocket itself, you would just tell me that it was CG. So,
not necessarily. I would put a question, say, well, how do I know that's real?
Well, how do you know it isn't?
Something's being presented to me and I'm expected to believe it.
Well, seeing is believing as much as believing is seeing.
Well, I don't think so. Perception's not always right, is it?
Yeah, but then why does that mean that your perception is better than mine?
All I'm doing is questioning it. I'm asking to prove what people are presenting to me. I don't know why you have a problem with that I'm saying, well, if you're telling me that's true, then could you prove it to me?
But again, my point being that if I was to try and prove it to you, couldn't you just say that it was all CG?
Yeah, but a photograph is not proof, and a video is not proof. Because with today's modern technology, they can have Mickey Mouse going around Pluto and make it look real. So a photograph and a video is not proof of anything. We need something more substantial to prove that people actually go to space. Did you ever see the Challenger disaster where 7 astronauts died when it exploded?
Yeah.
Well, if you research that, you'll see they're still alive.
Okay.
Their names are there, where they work, the universities. Now, that just proves nobody's on any rockets in particular.
Like I said, I have to actually go.
Okay, I know I was going against what you already believe, but thank you very much for your time anyway. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Carry on. Yeah, just carry on. Again, seems like a hard one to do, it doesn't exist. The Coriolis effect, there's no actual snipers taken in the UK. If you do research and speak to genuine snipers, no snipers taken in the Coriolis effect in the UK. Well, because they sometimes do a test, don't know if you saw the test of the Coriolis effect, where they'll fill up a sink of water on the equator, and then as they'll move the sink of water from the equator to one side of the equator, let the water out, and it's been one way.
There's a sort of model of what the Earth's like.
Yes.
And here at the nighttime part, there's an unobstructed view of the sun, so why wouldn't you be able to see the sun at night if this model were true?
Yeah, well, we don't believe the sun is 93,000 miles away.
Yeah.
We believe it's a lot closer, it's a lot smaller,
yeah.
It's more like a torch beam,
right,
rather than illuminating the whole planet.
So if you imagine
a wee torch beam going around the Earth,
yeah,
you're only going to see part of it lit up.
So do any other stars in the universe have this torch beam effect where they only shine in one direction?
Well, I don't think they actually exist.
You don't think other stars exist?
Well, if I'm being honest with myself, all I see are lights in the sky. Anything more than that, I'm repeating what somebody else has told me.
Yeah. But you can build in bigger theories about you know, celestial bodies, and you can think, well, there's no reason to think our sun's different to those stars.
Yeah, but that's not very intelligent, if you don't mind me saying, argument.
Because it's a more simple argument, more elegant.
I could say that all the snooker balls on the table are round, so therefore the table must be round.
No.
It's the same argument.
No, it's not the same argument.
But why is it not the same argument?
Because you're not comparing like for like. You're saying, this snooker ball is round, I can feel it. That one over there looks round, it probably is round. You're not saying there's a table over there with snooker balls on it, therefore the table is round. You're not comparing like with like. So our star is the sun, and we should assume that it's the same as all the other stars in the world without a reason to suppose that it wouldn't be.
So you're using the word assume?
Yes.
Okay, science isn't built on assuming.
It is built on assumptions.
Theory is built on assumption, but scientific proof is not built on assumption.
Well, it's built on the assumption of the uniformity of nature.
But while it's something a theory, yes. But to be accepted as a fact, it must be proven more than assumption.
So there's a torchlight effect here. So the people on the night side can't see.
Well done.
The people on this side can't see the sun. I don't understand. So, okay, you seem to think that satellites don't exist because if they got higher and higher, they would melt because it's too hot.
Oh, not so much that. I'd give you £500 now if you can go and find real footage of a real satellite in space.
Well, there's footage from satellites of
footage.
Earth.
But
so
then,
would that work equally well? But you'd say it was doctored.
If you don't mind me saying so, you're taking on second-hand information.
Yeah.
As a belief.
Don't you take on second-hand information?
Oh, wait, can we just stay with this with the satellites that you mentioned? People do not see satellites themselves. They take it on faith. They believe what they've been told.
Have you ever been to Australia?
No.
Do you believe it exists?
Well, it's not a belief for me.
Well, of course it is. You either believe it exists or you believe it doesn't exist.
But you're telling me I have a belief and I'm trying to tell you I don't have any beliefs.
You don't have any beliefs?
No, I don't have any beliefs.
Okay. So if, I don't know, a family member was stranded in Australia and they needed a flight home, would you say, I just don't believe that Australia exists? You'd have to commit to a belief at some point.
I think, if you don't mind me saying so, I think you're very black and white and full of conclusions here. I don't necessarily dismiss it, and I don't necessarily believe it until I can verify it for myself.
I think that you do believe many things that you take on second-hand evidence. And that if you didn't, you would know next to nothing. Nothing beyond what's currently in your surroundings.
I just told you I don't discount it. It may be plausible, it may be feasible, believable,
right. But
I don't discount it. I just put it on pending until I can verify.
So you don't discount that there could be, the Earth could be a globe and that the satellite images that you're seeing are actually not doctored, they're genuine. And that there isn't a massive international conspiracy all designed to make us believe something.
People use this word conspiracy to mock something different.
Yeah.
Looking across the road.
Well,
yeah.
A conspiracy is a
group. Do you think they lie to you?
Sometimes. Well, no, generally
no.
Not. But
do you think the government doesn't lie to you?
No, sometimes, maybe. I mean, it's a difficult question to answer because you wouldn't know if they'd done so successfully, would you? If you successfully lied.
No, but you'll know when they haven't done it successfully. You can document all the lies that they've told you.
Right.
You don't think the government lies to you?
Well, it's not just the government, you see. It's everyone in the world.
But I was just trying to start with a base route. Sorry, big pardon.
That's all right, man.
Conspiracy doesn't have to be a derogatory word. People conspire when there's a group of people who get together to make others believe something which isn't the case. That's what must have happened for me to believe that the world is round. You're believing that some group of people know that the Earth is flat.
You're telling me I've got a lot of beliefs, and I've told you I don't have any beliefs.
Well, I'm making inferences. I mean, you've handed out this leaflet.
You that leaflet.
Oh, well, the woman did. Okay, I don't really have any more questions, but it's been interesting to talk.
Well, thank you very much for your time.
All right, see
thank
you later.
You want to say, what was your response to that?
That the Earth is flat?
The Earth is flat.
Well, it's not.
It's flat.
It isn't. Clearly it's flat.
200 proofs, Earth is not a spinning ball.
Why is the Earth flat, Governor?
I know that it says that on there, but I'm just questioning if we live in a ball or not.
Well, personally, I believe the Earth isn't flat. It's just a little hunch I've got.
I have a question. So, there must be more than 70 space agencies worldwide. Are you telling me that every single space agency, all those astrophysicists, all those employees,
they're lying,
are hiding something from the rest of the world? Or are you telling me that there's some like greater power that's kind of like
hiding it,
like dictating this workforce?
Can I ask you to turn around for a second?
Yeah, sure.
Do you believe that people in there lie to you?
Sure, the politicians lie.
So why would NASA not be lying to you?
Because they send...
But there are also private space agencies, SpaceX.
So
Elon Musk,
all these different countries
sends a current space.
Who invade countries illegally. individually together. They're not working together.
What do you mean, like?
He's saying that they're all
liars. You're talking about colonies.
Look, you see, look here. Wait, get the camera, bring it over here. Yeah, come here.
Yeah.
Be living. Yeah, it's a lie.
Wait, but like, what do you mean by that? Like,
yeah.
Do you think you've been told the truth about the world which you live in?
I think that the earth is not flat.
One at a time.
I just don't think that private agencies, along NGOs, with government agencies like NASA or SpaceX, yeah, which is a private agency, are like upholding this lie together.
What if they're all controlled by the one umbrella?
Right, okay, let's look, okay, we've got the point, maybe they're lying, but okay, they're not lying.
If you're going to ask questions, you've got to answer my questions.
Yeah. Fair enough, it's got a good point there.
I've suggested to you that perhaps they're all under one umbrella and they're not as divided as they're trying to portray to you.
Sure.
What do you think about that?
I think that...
Should we science him? Talk about the Coriolis effect.
Banging. I mean, I just feel like, you know, since the beginning of time, the Greeks knew that the Earth was round when they saw the top of a sail emerge off the horizon before...
Nicholas Copernicus.
Before the bottom.
Let's just do one point at a time.
Nicholas Copernicus.
Let me respond to that.
Nicholas Copernicus, the guy who found out that the Earth was not flat.
Copernicus.
Yeah.
That ship that you think is going over the horizon, all you have to do is take a zoom camera or telescope and you'll see the bottom of that boat again, proving it's not going over the curvature. It's just going to have your line of perspective.
Well.
Now that's one answer I can prove to you that it's not a ball. No.
Okay. Now let me prove to you.
Just let me finish. And rather than taking second-hand information and a belief, we can observe through our own natural observations. And we can see buildings miles away that we shouldn't be able to see on a curvature of the
Earth. Well, the Earth is huge.
No, it's only 25,000 miles circumference.
25,000?
Yeah, 25,000. Now, that's the curvature chart there. It's 8 inches per mile squared. After 3 miles,
right,
it's like
so
70...
it drops 8 inches.
It's about 73 feet after 3 miles.
Okay.
Now, I shouldn't be able to see a lighthouse 60 miles away. I can. These are the figures that we're presenting.
Yeah, but the Earth isn't... The Earth has terrain that's higher and lower. So let's say... Yeah, so let's say even if it was 75 feet away, but the 75 miles away, but the terrain there was raised...
Yes, but we can see a lot across the channel, the English and the French channel.
Wait, tap me in here, tap me in. Please, I beg you.
Thank you, my friend.
20
miles away.
Yeah.
Now, we can see obstacles,
yeah,
as we should be able to see, according to the curvature of there.
Okay.
Can you explain the Coriolis effect, then, of the flat Earth?
No, can you explain it?
I can.
Go on then.
Right, Northern Hemisphere, of the round surf, like the round... Yeah, circular. Yeah. Sphere. Yeah.
No, I'm not saying yes, but...
Okay, the Northern Hemisphere, water turns clockwise.
I don't...
Southern Hemisphere, water turns anti-clockwise when going in by gravity.
How do you know that?
You could...
I've seen videos about that.
Yeah, you can go, I can go put the water, it'll turn that way. I can go South America, turn the other way.
Have you done that?
I have.
I've seen
personally, I have been to South America.
I've been in a house where you can...
I've been to Brazil.
Both drains in one house go opposite ways.
Opposite ways, do you know why that happens?
In one house. Because the shape of the sink.
No, it's not the shape of the sink. The shape of the sink is always going to be circular, 100% of the time.
If you don't mind me saying so...
Of course.
I think you're talking a lot and you're repeating what you've been told, but you're not listening to what I'm saying.
I've been to Northern Hemisphere, water turns that way. Southern Hemisphere, water turns that way.
But you're not...
I'll explain. The reason of this is because the gravitational field strength is different in different ways.
Well, yeah?
The field strength is the same, sorry, but the direction's different.
Question. I have two questions.
Because it's a sphere.
Firstly, how do you explain day and night? And secondly,
that's how you explain day and night.
Actually, yeah, how do you explain? So wait, this is your day and night. Why doesn't the sun light this? Why can't you see the sun from there?
What do you mean?
Surely if you're here, there's nothing that's actually blocking it. We can see stars from millions of light years away, and you're telling me I can't see the sun?
That's just our design, but the sun is a lot smaller and a lot closer. Now it goes round the Earth like a torch beam, rather than a complete illuminating hole, which is a lot lower, smaller, and closer to Earth. It's more like a torch.
How do you explain the equator being hotter?
But I don't see your commenting on what I'm saying.
I don't believe that. I just don't believe it. The sun's smaller. That just sounds ridiculous.
Why is it ridiculous?
Because the scientists can calculate by from taking light that's at the top of the of the sun and lightness at the bottom of the sun, and they calculate if they, when they, where they both meet, they can calculate the angle, which can tell them how far away it is.
But you tell me what a scientist is telling you. How do we verify that?
Because that's maths. That's just like facts.
But maths is a language that helps explain things. It does not prove anything in existence.
Fair enough.
No, mathematics will tell you that. It's a language. It cannot prove anything in nature.
Yeah.
It helps explain theories, so it doesn't prove anything.
Okay, but also then how, fair enough, but then how...
You think the moon is flat and the sun is flat, is
how round. How can this person not see the sun? Why is that, you know, even if you are saying the sun revolves around the top...
It's like my finger going round, a light. It's not shining up the whole planet.
Well, what about, why is the bubble always round? You know, is Mars round? Is Mars flat?
I don't believe Mars exists.
What about other stars?
Well, tell me what you see. Describe what you see.
I see other stars. What are other stars?
No, you're talking about Mars. What do you see?
I don't see anything.
You don't see anything.
But I trust in...
So it's a belief then?
It's a belief.
Right, okay. Thanks for being so honest.
It's a belief. I have to agree. You know, I haven't actually seen it myself.
Yeah, it's secondhand information.
I have to agree to that.
Secondhand information.
Sure.
Even the people who do see it, they can't verify that's a solid sphere. All they can verify is it's a round disc.
Sure.
Now, we can have round disc lights up there for all you know. How can we verify the planets?
Because we've, you know...
Do you see when rockets take off?
Why? I've seen
our critical footage. Why is there not cameras all over that rocket?
Oi, Charlie, he's got a plane.
Because that's...
That's
the greatest adventure of mankind, leaving Earth orbit, going into a vacuum. Why is there no footage of that?
There have been, haven't there? From the windows of the spacecraft.
No, I'll give you £500 if you can show me that footage now. I've been studying this for 4 years. There's no footage.
I've seen footage from a spacecraft of the Earth.
Yeah, but how do you know that's there? We want to see cameras, you know, the whole journey, not just take off and landing. Into Cavendish, but into his barn and claim he's seen the gravitational pull between two lead balls.
Yeah.
It's word of mouth. Now, my critical thinking is that, why is that not demonstrated in every school and university for me to see? Science should be demonstrable, repeatable, or measurable. That's word of mouth. That's not scientific. Did you know since Cavendish sticks into the ground,
There's
been 5 scientific experiments proving the Earth didn't move? Did you know about those?
I didn't.
Yeah, and I say to science students, why did you not know about these? You're studying science, and you didn't know there's 5
historical... What did they
say? Well, they went out to measure the movement of the Earth.
What did the students say?
They said they'd never heard of it.
Okay.
Now, you researched the Cavendish experiment, Halley's
failure.
What about,
like, you know, I'm looking at this this water thing, and you're saying that the water shouldn't bend, right?
No, not shouldn't. Water does not bend.
Water does not bend.
No.
But what about gravity?
Well, you...
So pulling towards the centre of the Earth. Where does gravity pull towards?
But how do you know gravity pulls the water to...
Because I can feel it. I can feel myself going, probably being pulled down.
I don't feel it. How can you feel it and I don't feel it?
I can drop an apple and it gets pulled down to the Earth.
Yeah, but you believe that drop because there's a force pulling it down, but you can't...
What could it be? What do you think it's this moving up? The ground beneath is moving up?
It's a simple explanation. A scientific explanation before it came with the theory of gravity. It's density and buoyancy. The molecules of this camera is heavier than the molecules of the air, so it will drop. A helium balloon is lighter than the air, so it will rise. It's simple. But they tell you it's gravity holds vast oceans to a ball without any proof. And you believe it. And you were 5 years old when they told you lived in this ball.
Yeah.
You're naive, you're young, you're impressionable, your critical thinking hadn't developed, you trusted in adults.
For what reason would they do that?
Well, when a detective comes across a murder scene, he doesn't say, why did they kill him? First they establish the facts. Was there a murder committed?
Why would the government want me to not believe that the Earth is flat? What are they hiding from?
I don't believe in this. This is going to be on YouTube.
I know you said that. Well, that's for you to find out for yourself rather than me to tell you why you're hiding it.
Okay. What do you believe in?
But if you don't accept the fact that you may have been lied to, now people are not open-minded because they're closed. They're full of conclusions. To me, that's brainwashing. No matter how much you think you're right, you should be a bit open.
Sure, I am.
That's what science should be.
I still don't believe that Earth is flat.
I'm not asking you to believe it, I'm just asking you to question what you've been told.
I do agree with that.
Yeah.
You should have the questioning.
Yeah, and science should be demonstrable, repeatable, and measurable.
Yeah.
Now, they can't show you a working model of water with a ball. They can't prove gravitational pull.
Okay, so what about, so on your point on gravity, how, you know, it could just not exist and it's just densities. What about when someone blows a bubble and it always forms a round shape?
Yes.
And how things naturally, you know, are attracted to each other?
Well, you say that, but I would only ask you, well, I used to believe that, but then I would say, now, well, what's the proof of that?
Well, things are naturally attracted together, so, you know, if you were to put a...
Why's my dog not being attracted to you now?
Because we don't have much mass. When you have something as big as the mass of as the Earth,
so
it attracts things like the orbiting sun and us orbiting the solar system.
But that's not what science says. Look at the size of those balls. Excuse the pun, but Cavendish's balls aren't very big.
Yeah, sure.
But yeah, that's what science is based on. He observed the gravitation.
What's he doing?
He put two lead balls suspended,
right,
and he claimed he'd seen the smaller one move slightly.
But I have seen an experiment where you put two discs of paper on water, and they slowly attract together. Very, very, you know, it wouldn't happen with something with such a high mass, because you know, the attraction isn't strong enough. But I've seen experiments with small discs of paper.
I've seen that as well, but that doesn't prove gravity.
That proves that things are naturally attracted together, like we're attracted to the Earth.
Well, it doesn't prove it to me. It proves me that water's become more dense as it's been soaked, and it's in a
small container. Reason would they attract together?
Well, they attract together, they're just moving to the centre.
I could show you a video. They attract. It's a well-known experiment. Well, This isn't, you know, you can't expect two lead balls to attract together because they're so heavy.
But that's what science is based on.
But
Earth is heavy, you tell me planets attract each other.
But if you're comparing a lead ball to the Earth, that's ridiculous.
Oh, they're doing it, not me.
Maybe that's why no one's learned about that.
I agree with you, it's ridiculous, but that's written down as a scientific fact.
Maybe no one's learned anything about that. Maybe that's why that isn't in our school curriculum.
Well, I think if you go into science, that's what they'll tell you.
What benefit would it give to the government to miseducate us?
Well, perhaps the government doesn't even know the truth themselves.
So what, it's just been...
So you don't think, you think you've been told the truth in education?
I think that government send out satellites. And I think the satellites orbit the Earth. And I think that.
Have you heard the phrase that the winners write the history books?
Sure.
So you're telling me that you've never been lied to?
I'm telling you that there are satellites. I'm telling you that I've seen satellite images.
You hear what you're saying? I've seen images.
But they're satellite images. You know, there's no other way that could be captured. Like, you can't even Photoshop that. It's just.
Oh, yes. That's one of the things I researched first, was satellites.
What about the moon landing?
I fly drones, and I'm told it's connected to a satellite.
Is this your photo?
No. So I went looking for original footage of a satellite. 4 years I've been looking. I will give you £500 now if you have real footage of a satellite in space.
All right. What about, what did I say? I'm not sure. Okay, fair enough. I respect your opinion. I respect that, you know, we should criticise and try and challenge science. I don't agree with you, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
And that's okay.
And that's fine. I'm going to give you a card to watch a video.
What's your YouTube channel called?
I'll give you, that's my YouTube channel. But this is the most popular video on YouTube. It's called 200 Proofs Why Earth Starts Spinning Ball.
Thank you very much. John Smith, Globe Live. Thank you.
And everything you and I think about the heliocentric model is a belief. It's all second-hand information, isn't it?
Yeah, man, but I'm not sure if this is right or wrong, because I don't know. Maybe it's right, maybe it's wrong.
Yeah. But at the age of 5 years old, you were told you lived on a spinning ball, water going around it, and we both believed that.
Yeah.
Without any evidence.
Yeah, but I don't know, I didn't read into that.
Yeah.
I just believed it, but maybe if I read that, I get convinced more that it's spinning.
Well, if I had half an hour with you, I would convince you that you don't live on a spinning ball of water.
To be honest, I don't care if it's spinning or not.
But you see all the people dying around the world in poverty and hunger. NASA get 52 million a day to present you with cartoons of space. And I think that's criminal when you think of all the people who are dying around the world and they get 52 million a day. That doesn't bother you.
I don't talk in that, because it's none of my business, to be honest.
Well, it's everybody's tax fee.
No, I can help the poor unfortunate, but not by like disagreeing with NASA or how much they make. It's none of my business.
Or exposing the lies that they're presenting to them.
I'm not sure. I'm not. Who said they're saying lies?
You see that video there? That's the most popular video on the internet. 200 proofs why you're not on the spinning ball. Would you care to look at it?
Yeah, maybe I'm gonna give it a shot later.
Good,
eh? No, I memorized. Thank you.
Because a lot of people are very close-minded and
yeah.
And want to look at something different.
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
The athletes over here.
Very good.
It's bullshit.
They got it.
What does it actually mean?
That we don't live on a spinning ball, that's what we're
talking about. Is it flat?
You ever been on a plane? So in the same way...
What was the neck?
Yeah?
What was the neck?
You're flat and flat?
Yeah.
The ground, is it curving or is it flat?
I don't know. I thought I'm always a slate.
I always thought the earth was a cube.
That's just me.
Can you watch one YouTube video? It's got 200 proofs why the earth is not spinning ball.
Oh, I've got a YouTube channel.
Have you?
Yeah.
What's it called?
Richie Arlane. Make sure you subscribe.
Richie Arlane, what?
Richie Arlane, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, well, I'll put it on that channel there.
Yeah.
Put up your gang signs and everything,
it'll
be on YouTube.
I'm a flat earther now.
Watch that video, guys. 200 proofs.
I will. Thank you.
Cheers, guys.
For watching, I hope you enjoyed this video presentation. If you did, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, like the video, and share it on your favorite social media sites. There's a lot more to come, so stay tuned, and we'll see you back next time.